Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. The success of bird parents is when the baby birds leave the nest to make their own nest somewhere. It gives us immense pleasure as parents to see your own kids becoming independent, finding their own way, facing their own struggles and finding their own solutions for them. But what they leave back is an empty nest. These kids are part of your day-to-day life. Our whole life probably revolved around them. And suddenly, not finding them as a part of your day can be very difficult to deal with. And this is not just for moms, but even fathers sometimes really struggle with the emptiness syndrome. This is that time of the year now when the universities are restarting, and many of you proud parents must be preparing to send your kids off to the university for a better education, for better career. This is also a time to make sure that you are preparing for the empty nest that they are going to leave behind. I spoke to my friend Manasi Joshi, who is a clinical psychologist with over a decade of experience. She also has a special interest in child-parent relationship. Let's hear it from her. What is this emptiness syndrome and what can be done about it?
Over the years, there has been a continuous increase in the number of students that go abroad. There are better opportunities or there are better standard of living, and they eventually study and settle down there, which in turn gives rise to feeling of emptiness that parents suffer, or they feel lonely, they feel suddenly I have nothing to do, what do I do now? Why does that happen and can we avoid it? Can we just talk about how we can avoid the situation, and if at all it's troubling us, what we can do about it? I think the basis of all that is over-involvement in child rearing, which is very common in our kind of societies, when it's a child is looked upon not as an individual, but it is so-and-so's son and so-and-so's daughter instead of an individual a person. So then what happens is the entire focus, entire energy of parents is involved into doing the best for this child. Now the new era has given so many opportunities which were not there when these parents were learning, and they want to fulfill all of those, which is not a bad thing, it's a good thing. They want to give best to their child, and in the process then there is some kind of involvement which is dysfunctional to a certain extent. A child is probably looked upon as my responsibility, or to an extent my support for my old age. So I'm investing right now into my child so as when I'm old he would or she would give me that kind of support or help or whatever is required. Nothing wrong, but you know, it's looked upon as he has to pay me back. He has to, if I've done so much for him throughout the years, then I'm supposed to get something in return. It's not a business, right? So child rearing cannot become a give and take kind of a situation. Also to an extent, like children fall prey to peer pressure, my child studies abroad is also a pressure that peers of the parents might be facing. So and so's child is not so educated, he's not so brilliant, but he could afford, and because they have money he could go, then why not I send my child also there, and if I can afford and substitute what I could not do that time. So maybe to begin with, we need to have a little realistic assessment of whether really we don't have opportunities in our state, our country, and whether my child has that kind of caliber, capacity to go abroad, or it's because it's kind of a status symbol that I want my child to have a better kind of lifestyle, better kind of education, so on and so forth. So understand, once they go, then what to do. Our feeling of emptiness can be a burden to the child who is settling in a new environment. The studies, the pressures, the kind of people that they meet, and here the expectation of being in touch. You know, constantly tell me what happened today, tell me how did you do your first day. There is excitement, I understand, for parents also to know. But if it becomes like a, what do we call, helicopter parenting, that you want to be there for everything, small little aspects of the child. If we can give a little more space and have trust that the child will definitely talk to us when there is anything worth discussing, then maybe we can have our own life apart from raising children. It's very important that parents, apart from being parents, need to have their own interests and hobbies and things to do throughout, even before the child is of the age wherein he moves out. So parents need to be active. Parents have to be involved with each other, with the kind of work and environment they have, so as to reduce this kind of emptiness, so as to reduce this kind of feeling that I'm no more of any use. Most of these parents feel that along with their own midlife crisis. So they are suffering their own midlife crisis, wherein that feeling of loneliness is also there. I'm not of any use anymore. If my life was continuously revolving around that one particular individual whom I want to give the best and make the best of all, then probably pay attention to your relationship with your spouse as well in that situation. Maybe we were too busy in raising children, too busy in earning money. Now is the time probably we can connect to each other, have some time for the spouse as well, make activities, plan things that you can enjoy together and also satisfy your own interests and need. So I guess it's more important to have meaning to your life overall, apart from having just one focus of having the best generation for tomorrow. So what are some of the things that can be done when you're feeling so empty, when you're feeling so lonely, and at one side of your mind you're also worried whether your child is safe? Then what can be done if not hover them with that kind of attention, if not get over involved in them? But right now, if my child is abroad and I'm feeling very lonely, what all can I do? Like we said, that we can have kind of activities which as a family, as a spouse together, we enjoy. Also get involved in the NGOs, in the support groups that do a lot of meaningful work around wherever you are situated. There's no dearth of work that you can offer as volunteer, as a part-time worker. It's not to generate any kind of income at that point of time, but it is more to do with keeping yourself active and busy. So then you can have the same feeling of being useful, being important to somebody in this manner. So maybe have meet other parents. You can have those kind of meetings, kind of support groups, wherein meet other parents whose children have also moved away and they are also doing some kind of education or work abroad. There are a lot of support groups even for elderly. So when you are in the age group above, when you have retired and you feel that there is nothing more to do, there are a lot of activities that are taken up by such groups. Or you can attend different programs, which are available for free also. You can invest into watching good movies, reading good books. Maybe you have to a little dig into your past, what was left behind at that time. And you'll definitely find things that if I had time, I would have loved to draw or paint or, listen to music. Now is the time to do all of that. And there's no age to learn something new. So you can always enroll yourself for some classes, some activities, yoga or music for that matter, and learn a new skill. That way your brain stays active, it stays productive, and gives you a feeling of being useful and being productive.